What's up, guys? It's Gary McCready, host of the HVAC Know-It-All podcast, and on this video, we're going to do something very cool. We are going to measure the actual BTU output of a rooftop unit. We're going to do it with three tools, or two tools, but three in total. One, the 405i, Testo Smart Probe, hot wire, anemometer that measures airflow. The 605i, thermo-hygrometer. We're going to use two of those. Okay, so we're going to take those three tools, you're going to need a measuring tape as well, the Smart Probes app, and we're going to go into the building. We're going to take some readings, and we're going to get the actual BTU output, the heating BTU output of a rooftop unit. Stay tuned. This video is brought to you by Harago.com, a trades-only platform helping you find the right job or the right candidate. Harago.com. Best in trade. Okay, so here's the rooftop we are going to take some readings from, and we're going to find out exactly what the BTU output in heating is of this rooftop. Now, if we look at the nameplate, we can see that it has 100,000 BTU an hour input with an 80% thermal efficiency. So we're going to test all that out right now. So in order to get our CFM, we have to traverse this duct. We've got three holes drilled in it. We are gonna do 9 points. Okay, we're gonna do the 9 points and we're gonna plot it with the Smart Probes app. So I have the app opened into volume flow for duct, but we need to enter in the duct size. And we do that by going to settings, config measurement, and we put our duct size in here. So I've got the measurement in 12, by 16 inches. We are a multi-point average, so we're gonna do 9 points. And here is our supply air. We've picked supply air, not return. Okay, so we have the 405i fully extended with the cap at the top opened up. So we expose the hot wire. So we're gonna insert it, and we have to have the hot wire in the airstream. So we're gonna leave it as such, and we're gonna insert it in all the way to the end of the duct. So now we have a reading. We're going to map that as our first point, and we hit the orange circle at the bottom of the tablet there to map it as our first point. So we're on our last hole of the duct, okay? And I have it all the way in, and the way we capture the reading, just to show you guys, is we just come down here and we hit this button. So I have seven captures, okay? And what we wanna do is we wanna pull it out, capture again, and then pull it out almost to the end and capture again. That will give us our 9 points. So basically we've taken 9 points across the cross-sectional area of this duct with the duct measurement. That will give us our CFM. So as we finish off on the results page, we have the date and time that we performed the test. My date and time needs to be updated. It's not correct. But the more important information, the information we need, is right here. There's our CFM for the 9 points. There's our temp. There's our feet per minute, and then our supply air that we're measuring. So now that we have the CFM, we can plug that in to the formula to get the actual BTU output of the machine. Okay, so we have one of the 605i's in the return air stream right there. And then we have the other 605i in the discharge airstream right there. Just on a side note here, guys, I changed the position of this 605i just because I felt it was too close to the heat exchanger, maybe getting some residual heat off of it. So I used the pre-drilled hole here, and we're gonna take the measurement like this. So we're up and running. We're taking live readings from the Smart Probes back to the app. Right here you see the CFM. This is the readings that we took. Okay, I had to manually enter that in by going to settings and configure measurement, entered that in. So now we have these readings up here. We're gonna turn the machine on and see what happens. Right here, we're reading our BTUs per hour based on these temperatures and the CFM. That's gonna change when we turn the machine on. And this is where we're gonna get our readout of our actual BTUs per hour that the machine is doing. So we've run this unit now for about 5 minutes to allow everything to stabilize, all these numbers to stabilize. And what I'm seeing is we're getting around 87,000 BTUs per hour out of this machine. Now you remember, according to the nameplate, It was an 80% efficiency out of 100,000 BTUs per hour. So we're actually doing a little bit better than the nameplate says this machine can do. So let's do a recap here. Okay, so let's recap what we just did there. The first thing we did is we got our CFM that we needed from the supply duct to incorporate into the cooling heat load calculation portion. The way we did that is we took the 405i smart probe, we connected it to the app, we took 9 readings, okay? So if you can imagine a rectangular duct, we went furthest, middle, closest, and so on to get our 9 points. So what the app did is it took those 9 points, it averaged it out, and because we put our dimensions of the duct into the app, it calculated our CFM. The CFM is needed to calculate the output, the load output of the machine. So then we went to the roof. We put a 605i in the return, a 605i in the supply. We connected those probes to the app, made sure the probes are flashing green, connected to the app, we got the live readings. We went into settings in the heating or the cooling heating load calculation portion of the app. We went to settings, we entered in our CFM. The CFM stays constant here because it's a belted three-phase fan. It's not a VFD driven fan, it's gonna stay constant. So we're comfortable putting in that constant number. We fired up the heating. We let it stabilize over 5 minutes, and it spit back out at us 87,000 BTUs, roughly around that area. Now that is higher than what the nameplate says. Okay, so it looks like it's running more efficient than the nameplate actually states. So anyway, guys, that is a quick test you can do to check the efficiency and check the BTU output, the actual output of a machine. Happy HVAC.